When it was said that the concept of a spontaneous natural order in Chinese philosophy influenced the European physiocrats, the mentioned concept is related to Zhiren, which is the Chinese word for by itself, and used to refer to something spontaneous, that happens by itself, not by external intervention. In this sense, a natural state. Jason Gregory says, the naturalness of Zhiren, to seek refuge. From these unnatural systems, we need to understand nature itself. The organic pattern of the individual is our innate nature driven by T, virtue. Nature, then, has no relationship to force, control, or power. The order and pattern of nature is not a forced order, as nature is not bound by external influence or control. The Taoist term for nature is the Chinese word Zhiren, which means that which is spontaneously of itself. When a natural organism is in harmony with all life, it grows of itself spontaneously. Zhiren can only arise of itself without external compulsion. Zhiren's relationship with Wu Wei is therefore quite intimate. It can be understood that Zhiren is the state that is established by itself spontaneously when Wu Wei is practiced. By reading some appearances of Zhiren and the three main books of Taoism, the concept can be better assimilated. Tao Te Ching, Chapter 17. How irresolute did those earliest rulers appear, showing by their reticence the importance which they set upon their words. Their work was done and their undertakings were successful, while the people all said, it happened spontaneously, that is, Zhiren. Tao Te Ching, Chapter 23, Abstaining from Speech. Marks him who is obeying the spontaneity of his nature, that is, Zhiren. A violent wind does not last for a whole morning, a sudden rain does not last for the whole day. Tao Te Ching, Chapter 51, All things are produced by the Tao, and nourished by its outflowing operation. They receive their forms according to the nature of each, and are completed according to the circumstances of their condition. Therefore all things without exception honor the Tao, and exalt its outflowing operation. This honoring of the Tao and exalting of its operation is not the result of any ordination, but always a spontaneous tribute, that is, Zhiren. Tao Te Ching, Chapter 64. Therefore, the sage desires what other men do not desire, and does not prize things difficult to get. He learns what other men do not learn, and turns back to what the multitude of men have passed by. Thus, he helps the natural development, that is, Zhiren, of all things, and does not dare to act with an ulterior purpose of his own. Li Zi, Book 2, The Yellow Emperor. Then the Yellow Emperor sighed heavily and said, my fault is wanting of moderation. The misery I suffer comes from over-attention to my own self, and the troubles of the empire from over-regulation in everything. Thereupon, he threw up all his schemes, abandoned his ancestral palace, dismissed his attendants, removed all the hanging bells, cut down the delicacies of his cuisine, and retired to live at leisure in private apartments attached to the court. There he fasted in heart, and brought his body under control. For 3 months he abstained from personal intervention in government. Then he fell asleep in the daytime, and dreamed that he made a journey to the kingdom of Hsu of Breve, situated I know not how many tens of thousands of miles distant from the Kai state. It was beyond the reach of ship or vehicle or any mortal foot. Only the soul could travel so far. This kingdom was without head or ruler. It simply went on of itself, that is, Zhiren. Its people were without desires or cravings. They simply followed their natural instincts, that is, Zhiren. Chuangzi, Chapter 7. How to govern? The sage replied, resolve your mental energy into abstraction, your physical energy into inaction. Allow yourself to fall in with the natural order of phenomena, that is, Zhiren, without admitting the element of self, and the empire will be governed. As Taoism deals with universal issues, many commentators argue about the political consequence of the concept of Zhiren. As Jason Gregory says, superficially, this perspective may be incorrectly perceived as anarchy, but there is a major difference. Anarchists' motives are driven by what they oppose. On the other hand, the sages who understand Zhiren just follow their own nature without any concern for institutional or organizational power, because they are content to let such things run their course. An anarchist is still distracted by external influences. So, if the world is thrown into anarchy, then the motive destroys the project. Nature is as it is and can have no motive, nor is it a project to embark upon. Doubt can never be induced, as its principle happens spontaneously of itself. Zirun. Anarchy is an attempt to induce Tao so as to bring about a real order through an intellectual, artificial decision to abandon the ways of society. Though anarchy in some sense is a step in the right direction, it is not a suitable method for liberating the world, because it cannot avoid having an agenda. The Russian evolutionary theorist Peter Kropotkin understood this subtle difference between anarchy and Zirun. Kropotkin postulated that if we were to leave people alone to follow their own nature, a real social order and true government would emerge out of the current system. Influenced by Adam Smith, F.A. Hayek is perhaps the intellectual who better developed the concept of spontaneous order in the West, a concept that has been so familiar in the East for a long time. The Austrian economist divides the order into two types, taxes and cosmos, that is, the made order that can be referred to as an exogenous order, an arrangement, a construction, an artificial order, and the grown order that can be referred to as a self-generating or endogenous order, most conveniently described as a spontaneous order in English, that is, the order that grows by itself. What Hayek describes as taxes can be understood as rinzhuo in Chinese philosophy, which means man-made, artificial in Chinese language, while cosmos is related to Zirun. The end.